Welcome, welcome to the Smiling Suffer podcast. On the mic is Corey, and I have here my boy, Wale, a.k.a. the Black James Bond.
That's right.
Let's go. Let's go. That's that was right. Fountains by Drake featuring Tems, our girl Tems.
One and only Tems.
We called it, didn't we? We called this shit. We called this shit early.
All hits, no misses.
Early, man.
There's actually no artist I've name dropped here that has flopped.
Early. We called this shit early.
All of them, man.
So right now, Tems is...
Tems is the one we called.
She's got all the attention on her right now. There are people that want to work with her in the industry.
She's doing a good job.
She is the most streamed artist right now.
African artist on Spotify.
African Afrobeat artist. Afrobeat alti, whatever you want to call it.
African artist on Spotify.
African?
Yeah,
really?
I don't think there's anybody that's higher.
Even Casper?
Casper who?
Casper like Nieuwvest. And now that guy from South Africa.
AKA?
No, the other one. The rapper.
That's AKA.
No, well, there's another rapper.
Casper has... Tems has 12 million.
12 million.
Casper has 300,000.
Okay. My bad.
Spotify, like... No, the top... So, I saw the only person I think that has in any other genre is Master KG.
Okay.
Master KG has 5 million monthly listeners.
Okay.
So, I think that's the only person that comes close to... I think it's Tems, Wiz, Burna...
Tems, Wiz, Burna, in that order.
In that order.
The spotlight is on Tems right now, man.
Spotify. This is just strictly Spotify.
I wonder what made Drake be like, you know what? Nah, man, I need this girl on my album.
He heard Essence.
Probably did.
There's no other
he probably
way.
Probably did.
Where I was he like, bro, he, Drake is a smart guy. Like,
he is.
You see, and the thing about Drake is this. Drake is quick. Drake is very, very quick.
He'd be Drake. He be hopping Drake on those
heard
trends
Odjo-Legba
with the quickness. With the quickness,
Drake had heard Odjo-Legba all right, so here it is: African artists with the most Spotify monthly listeners. Thames, at the time this tweet came out a day ago, it was 11.46 million.
Right, so now 12. We checked, it's at 12.
Okay, Wizkid 10.5, Burna Boy 9.2.
Okay.
Then the next person is Master KG.
Wow.
At 5 million.
Wow.
Mr. Easy at 4 million.
And this is 4.7. Probably just off of the Drake feature.
Then Davido.
The Drake and the Essence features.
Davido 3.1 million and Rema 3 million. So the top seven that I see on this list, six of them are Nigerian. Master KG is one.
Wow.
I do see some people like... their comments were like, oh, Nigeria has a population of X billion. Trust me, those monthly listeners are not the percentage of Nigerians on Spotify. Only just joined Nigeria this year.
Talent is talent.
So talent is talent. Like, how many Nigerians have
we got the talent
access to? It's cheap, but how many of them even have access to it? Not a lot of them, let's be honest. It's why I used to say, like, even our YouTube videos, I've said if Nigeria had better internet, our YouTube videos would have
way more
views, because we have way more people. Yes, yeah. But how many people are subscribed? There's a number. I think the number of people that subscribe is like 10% of the population. I think.
Really?
Yeah, or less, or something like that.
Oh, wow.
That have active subscriptions, you know, with like a mobile network plan or something like that. So
that's crazy. And you know, in Nigeria, to watch every video, they're gonna charge you.
People say their data. So
to watch,
and I think
data.
The thing they've used, I think the one that most Nigerians use is Boomplay. Boomplay. I think it's Nigerian too, owned by a Nigerian to an extent. So that's the one that they have, which is why I always say, like, you know, when you want to know, like, if you want to know what the streets probably like more, maybe go look at who's popping on Boomplay.
Because
I think, like, Jiggy, I think, like, that's where you're going to find more. But anyways, back to Thames. So Drake is smart. I'm pretty sure he heard that Essence and was like, look, I'm going to get this guy. And he did it first. Because now everyone else that gets that is like, you're copying it.
Yep. Speaking of Essence.
What?
Essence.
What was that you just pulled up?
Justin, some people, they were calling into question Thames' talent.
Let me see it.
All right. Let me pull it up real quick. This was on something I found. All right,
let's see what they have to say.
All right, so this was.
Gotta see the tweet.
There are plenty of female artists that can sing better than Thames. I'm yet to find what is unique about her voice, except a lot of PR and Twitter hype. Chidima's voice sends chills down my spine. Okay. Tiwa Savage sends chills as well. Yemi Alade and Omawumi are singers. Unfortunately, there's nothing unique about Thames, but you know the haters gonna come
out.
Let me finish.
There's no
unfortunately,
finish.
There's nothing unique about Thames' voice. Her voice is just normal to me. It doesn't send chills down my spine. I'm a musicologist, so I know what I'm saying.
Let me.
P.S. This is my own opinion. If you like Rachel from now till tomorrow, someone now replied.
That's YC.
YC replied. So he's like, down. Go lie down on top ice block. Since your spine defied you.
So let me. I think this is a problem we have with Nigerians sometimes. So we have this mentality that we think is just all about talent, right?
Mm-hmm.
You think Chidima has a better voice?
Yeah. It's not just.
It's
about
subjective.
That,
you know? But let's even say that. Yes. Chidima's hit song.
She may have a better range.
Yeah, range.
Voice.
But Chidima's hit song.
But
is,
to make a hit song is more than just having
Beyonce,
a good voice.
We've always said now, Beyonce doesn't have the best voice. Yep. Rihanna doesn't have the best voice.
There's so many people that have great voices.
Exactly.
And they're not Rihanna or Beyonce.
So, and then this thing is what also ruins us. And I bring it to soccer real quick. So, you remember I had this conversation recently when Ighalo tweeted favor over labor. There was a time he tweeted favor over labor, and somebody replied and said, this is a very funny tweet, that you work in a business where you actually have to work hard, and yet you are tweeting favor over labor. And a lot of Nigerians kind of abuse the person, like, what do you mean favor over labor? So when Ighalo got signed to Man U, they were all referencing, you see Ighalo said favor over labor.
Yeah.
But then I laughed because, okay, so favor over labor, right? So he was favored by God, that's what you're saying, right? And he got signed to Man U. Where is Ighalo today? He's playing for a team in Saudi Arabia. Ighalo played maybe.
He's still making that bread though.
Yes. So then, what is your objective?
Yeah.
Ighalo, you say he's making that bread in respect to what? Is he? We see what the hype of a 36-year-old Cristiano Ronaldo coming back to Man U.
Mm-hmm.
This is someone who was not just thinking of bread. This is someone who also labored.
I think
where I'm getting to is it's favor and labor. It's not one over the other. Yeah. We tend to think, oh, I'm blessed or I have talent. That's where it ends.
Yeah.
It's not like that. It's not only by talent. Or it's not only by being blessed, I'm sorry. You have to work hard to be the best because you're not the only person that's been blessed.
Yeah.
There are millions of people that... So
I don't know who Tim's manager is.
It's this young guy.
Whoever that guy is.
I think it's the same guy managing Omalley.
Oh, you know, really?
That's why
took
them to.
Yeah,
I know. Then I think his name on Twitter is like I am Donovan or something like
don't
that.
Don't worry, I'll find it and I'll plug it.
But anyways, back to what I was saying is, it's not about. So we talk about you say Chidima has range. Chidima's biggest song is Miss KDK or something like that. It's not. It's nothing. When you listen to it, the appeal is nothing close to anything Tems puts out.
It's
even though it's a good song,
it's not a global.
It's not
hit
a global
song.
Hit song. Mm-hmm. And this is where we make that mistake. So you talk about Omawumi having range. Yes, Omawumi can. There are a lot of, in fact, forget Chidima Omawumi. There are a lot of girls in the choir. There are a lot of women in the choir. Do you get
good? There are a dime a dozen.
There are billions of them out there.
There's so many singers.
You will hear them put.
They can sing their ass off.
They sing their ass off. But are they ready to be stars?
No.
And do they have what it takes to be a star?
No.
So it's not only favor.
We saw
label,
it in Thames. There was something about
Thames that I saw. Yeah, a performance
on that song.
Yeah. Try me. Yes.
And I was like,
I called it out. This is different.
This girl is unique.
This is unique. There's something
special.
Different about her. It's not just about
you're
her
special.
Voice, and it's hard work also. It's not just
it is.
She was blessed with the talent, but she's also taking it to the next level. So don't tell me this
it
person
is.
Has a better voice. You're talking Yemi Alade. Yemi Alade songs are all dumbo 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 music. Like, is that global? Like, are you
he just has to throw shit.
So it's like it's no. So and then I saw another person tweet something about how Tems is not milking this success from Essence, that it was like if I was Tems, I'll be everybody will know it's me, especially because it's my part of the song that they're always singing and this and that and that and that. But like again, you don't when you got it, you got it. You don't need to.
Everyone knew that when Essence came out, there was something very special
Wizkid's
about Tems
tweet.
On that track.
You need to find it. Wizkid
there was
tweeted
something about
after they
Tems
created
that
song. Wizkid tweeted. Tems and I just created magic.
There was something. There was something special.
Guess
about
who else made a song with Tems and tweeted something similar? Davido. It did.
What song?
It never came out.
Never did.
But he tweeted something that Tems and I or something. It's something.
I gotta take shots at Davido.
No, I'm just saying like.
Why you gotta do
no,
that?
No. I literally saw that tweet.
But while we're on Wizkid and Tems, let's talk about Essence, man.
It's an amazing
Essence
song.
Essence has been rising up the charts. It was at
confirm.
2 weeks ago.
Let me first of all confirm that tweet is real too. But it was at it's number 16.
It moved.
It's not
to,
no, actually. It wasn't number. It was outside the top 20.
Yeah, it was outside top 20.
Yeah, it was outside the top 20.
The last time we talked, it was like 50 something or 60 something. I don't remember. But now, where is Essence?
So Whiskey's tweet came out.
Number 12 or 13.
You know, Whiskey's tweet came out February 23rd of 2020. That's when he created
2020.
The song. Yeah, that's when he created the song. Last year, before the album.
Oh.
So he said, Tems and I created magic.
Oh, yeah, because the album dropped last year.
So February 23rd, he tweeted, Tems and I created magic. Now, when this came out, I saw it and I was like, hey, I like Tems. You know, I'm more interested. But a lot of people were probably like, why Tems?
Yeah.
And it's another thing, too, you're thinking is like, Wiz, why Tems? You know, but it takes a star to know a star.
Yeah. She's special.
It takes a star to see something special. We talk about Chidima. Wiz has a song with Chidima. You might have never heard it before. He has a song with her. He had a song, a remix to one of her songs years ago. Mm-hmm. I don't know if Omawumi and Wiz have a song, all these other people. But like again, it took a star. Wizkid was making the biggest album of his life.
Yeah.
Which is made in Lagos. Because if you notice one thing about Wiz, mm-hmm. I think he also had that mentality of I'm talented, I don't need to do much. So he was very nonchalant about a lot of stuff, and I think his status fell, and then he saw Burna Boy, who most of you don't like, but that nigga is actually fucking hard.
Burna Boy is working hard.
That boy
he's
is
hustling
working hard.
He's networking.
He's doing everything. He was just presenting, I think, GQ Awards recently. So I'm like, he's doing everything to get where he wants to be, and I think we saw that. And he started changing his nonchalantness to being very more appreciative of fans.
And like, guess what?
And look at where he is.
Guess what?
What?
Whiskey hasn't peaked.
He hasn't peaked, though.
He has not peaked.
He has not peaked.
He hasn't worked with all like the greatest producers. Yeah. He hasn't. He That's what
like
I realized.
It looked like it has.
Essence is not his peak.
No.
It's not.
It looked like he had peaked. Or it looked like he didn't care. But I think now he has seen what I put in more effort and care into this thing where it could get. So maybe Lagos was going to be his biggest album. And the reason I say this is because Made in Lagos was about 2 years late. Because he announced Made in Lagos. It was coming out, supposed to come out, I think, a year after Sounds from the Other Side. Sounds from the Other Side was 2017.
Yeah.
So that's 5 years late, actually. Or four years.
It took his time. 4 years.
It took his time. So it's 4 years after. Oh, when did it come out? Last year?
Last year.
So it's 3 years after.
Late last year.
So 3 years after. So he took his time. So he pushed it by 2 years because I said it was supposed to come out the year after. And he knew. And one thing about it was he stuck to his guns.
Yeah.
He knew this is the sound he wants to give us. Because remember, everybody clowned. A lot of people clown Sounds from the Other Side. That is whack.
Mm-hmm.
He put it out there. He put his Soundman Volume 1 mixtape out there, which a lot of people still clown. But that sound was the similar sound to Made in Lagos. And then you want to create the biggest album of your life. And you start including features like Thames. And you think it's by mistake. You think Thames has nothing special?
There's something special.
It's not about her voice. There's something very unique about her. He could have picked anybody.
Her lyrics are very they hit hard.
Then you're talking about Thames. Let's now bust your head again. Thames is not special, but Wiz picked her. Wiz has the choice of almost anybody in the industry.
Mm-hmm.
Fine. Let's say he doesn't have the choice of Rihanna, Beyonce, which I think Wiz actually at this point probably should be able to get one of them on the track.
Yeah. Yeah.
But then.
No, he already got Beyonce on the track.
On the track, Then Drake now picks the same girl that is not special. At least we know Drake has access to everybody.
And Drake is a scout.
If Drake is scouting you and you make his album, Drake scouted Wizkid before everybody else did in the industry.
He did.
If Drake is picking Thames, you think it's by fluke?
No, it's not.
You think it's by her voice is not unique?
I want to talk about Essence. Fuck about that. I want to talk about Essence. Essence has been rising up the charts.
And it's going to be top 10.
I think what gave it the boost, we can all agree, the JB boost, Justin Bieber.
Of course, which was a timely...
Justin Bieber. When they first dropped the track, I won't lie, I was like, I wasn't really crazy about the JB verse. I wasn't crazy about the JB feature. It grew on me. That song grew on me. The remix grew on me.
I love it.
And I kind of like that JB didn't try too hard to like try to emulate what he thought an Afrobeat artist would sound like. He just did his own thing. He put his own melody on it. He put his own spin on it.
Mm-hmm.
He had his own pop flavor, and I loved it.
Mm-hmm.
And this was like a few days ago in the Made in America concert. Let me play this really quickly. The Made in America concert. Whose set was this? JB, right?
Justin Bieber set. So Made in America has 2 days, right? Day one and day two. Day two is the pop. Before he plays, day two is the pop in day. We've been to America. You went there?
I didn't make it with you guys.
So the time we went, that was the year Jay-Z was there. So I think
That was also the year Wizkid.
This is when Wizkid was.
He flicked.
This was Wizkid had a.
He had sounds from the other side.
Yeah, no. Wizkid had a habit of canceling on American shows back then.
Yeah.
Made in America.
He felt he didn't have a big enough stage.
He felt like he didn't. That's why I'm saying, like, this guy at one point in his life had this chip on his shoulder that, look, I'm Wizkid, I have this talent. But again, it's not only talent, you need that labor to go with it. So he didn't show up. But that day, day two, is a 2 day festival held in Philly every year. But was owned by Jay Z.
They had it this run past by Jay Z.
They had this past weekend. They didn't have it last year because of COVID. Mm-hmm. So they had this past weekend, and day two headliner on the biggest stage was Justin Bieber at the end of it. So he was closing out the show.
Mm-hmm.
Now doing his set, Justin Bieber's set, he decides to bring out a special guest. He brought out other special guests, Chance the Rapper and some other people. But doing it, he decided to perform a song that is not his song, a song that he's featured on
someone else's song
that he brought Wizkid.
He knows now.
He brought Wiz to stage and they performed the whole song together. So it's not like this was Wizkid's set or Made in America invited Wizkid. This was Justin incorporating a song that is featured on,
mm-hmm.
with whiskey into a set.
And this was what it looked like.
And you can tell just you don't need no other body. Wah, wah, wah. Only you can hold my body. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Only you can hold
my body. JB's vibing. He made a video for this shit. Be by your side. I don't wanna forget those lonely nights. Ooh, so tell me that you gon' ride with me. Tell me that you never lie to me. Hey. Just wanna make you proud of me. Want you loving every side of me. I love the rhythm of your heartbeat. The way you're pushing up on me. I can tell that you want me. Sing it. Let me show you how it's gonna be. You don't need no other body. Yeah, 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 yeah. You decide. Let me. All right, yeah,
so Essence debuted at number 82 on the Hot 100.
Yes.
And it started going up the chart.
Mm-hmm.
And then the Justin Bieber version came out. And that shit shot it into the top 20. Like,
yeah.
ASAP.
ASAP.
Yeah, like ASAP. And that's what I was saying was, when I saw it, I was
it's like 12, right? 12 or 13, one of the two. It's 13?
I think it's going to beat top 10.
Oh, yeah. It was 16, and then it went to 13.
And I think it's going to beat top 10.
If you make it the top 10, if you make the top 10, no one can, honestly, no one can tell honestly, us anything anymore about Wizkid.
There is no Nigerian artist. Wizkid has been number one before. We all know that. Through
Drake's feature, One Dance.
But this is his song.
Yeah.
Yes, fine. Justin Bieber might have, but if it was a bad song, nobody would still listen to it. In fact, Justin Bieber would not even want to be on the song. You know,
and just if there's someone that can give you a boost, it's Justin Bieber. The number one song right now in the country is featuring Justin Bieber. Is this guy called Kid Laroi? A song called Stay, featuring Justin Bieber. Number one song. That's the kind of boost that JB can bring you, but. We're not going to give JB all the credit. We know that Starboy.
Of course.
He has the talent. He been had the talent for this shit.
Of course.
He been had that talent.
Of course.
And it was brilliant the way he was able to put this song together. He was able to put this album together, which I feel it should be a shoo-in for, you know, World Record of the Year, World Album of the Year. It should be a shoo-in. This song should also be a shoo-in to make like top 10 hit of the year. Not just that, I think he's already number 3 in R&B hip hop song of right now. He's number 3 at the moment. R&B hip hop. Mm-hmm. Essence. That's the record on there. This is a big deal. This is a huge freaking deal. And I want us to recognize this.
Let me read this. So Rolling Stone has a huge, there's a long article, and I won't read everything, but it talks about how Essence was created. It's titled You Don't Need No Other Body.
Yeah.
And it talks about the origins, and they interview people. They interviewed Wizkid, they interviewed Tems, they interviewed Jada, his manager, and P2J, Legendary Beat. But then they get to a section where it's about the remix. So they're like, okay, what happened? So there's a guy called Tay James. He's Justin Bieber's A&R.
Yeah.
So he goes, my mentor, DJ Alize, a legendary DC DJ, actually put me onto Essence. He was like, this is the song of the summer.
Mm.
This is what's been playing at all cookouts. Everyone loves this record. I fell in love with the record, and right then when I heard it, I'm already a Wizkid fan. Justin and I were headed. Okay, no, that's fine. Justin and I were headed to for vacation for Allison Keys. That's his Bieber's manager. And we were literally on the plane, and I was playing music for Justin. And I was like, "Hey, this is one of the hardest songs, if not the hardest songs, out right now." And once I played Essence for him, that became the song of the weekend.
Yeah.
We played it nonstop throughout every event we did. It was a birthday song. And then it goes on later to how Justin eventually was like, I got to do a remix. So this wasn't even an industry.
Yeah, thing. It was just his boy heard it. Heard he was it, like, you got to hop on this thing.
You got to listen to this. And it was like, bro, you know.
Dope record, man. Dope record. Nah, congrats to Wizkid, Baba. You're doing your thing, bro. doing your thing. Congrats. Major, major congrats. And I don't think you have peaked. I don't think people have seen your level of talent, your level of music making, feel good music. I'm telling you, man, Afrobeat to the world. This is it. This is what we've been waiting for. We do this Afrobeat podcast for how many years now? And we've been trying to tell people that, look, you guys, they have not peaked. They have not peaked. They have ways to go. And I still don't think they've peaked. What else was I going to touch on the agenda here?
Wait, let me read this. So,
oh, yeah. Whiskey sold out the O2.
We'll get to O2 first. Hold on.
He sold out the O2 already in 35 minutes. Wait,
so, hold on. So, it goes... we went to Cabo. Went to Cabo to celebrate Alison K's 40th birthday, blah, blah, blah. Tay and I had known about each other, but we actually met on the trip. Oh, this guy is also Whiskey's agent. So there's a guy that was Whiskey's agent, no, that was also on that trip. Mm-hmm. So he knew I represented Whiskey. I guess this is like from RCA. It was like, I was telling him about the upcoming Whiskey tour, and he was like, hey, we got to get Justin on this remix. I'm like, yo, I love this idea. Let's put it together. Then I hit Jada, and Jada sent me the files right away on text. Jada is Whiskey's manager. I'd reached out to Wiz. I tell him, hey, Justin really wants to do this record. Wiz was excited. When we got back into the States, Tay and I were like, let's start a group chat with me, Tay.
Wait, is this Tay Iwa?
No. Tay is the guy that, Tay James, is Justin Bieber's A&R.
Yeah.
So Justin Bieber's A&R, Whiskey's agent, we're on a trip together. Mm-hmm. A&R has already played the song for Justin. Agent is like,
he love it.
Guy, let's do remix. You get, so he's like, let's do group chat. And then he's like, they added, you know, the Tay guy, Whiskey, to Justin. And Josh, who's Justin Bieber's engineer. I go with my brother. I hope you're well and healthy. We've been playing your record all weekend long in Mexico. I wanted to introduce you as discussed to Justin Bieber and his amazing music team. Blah, 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 blah. Let's work and make some magic. Let's connect tonight. I'll send you legends. I'll let you legends take it from there. And then Tay, which is Justin Bieber.
Thank you for acknowledging they are talking to a legend. You're not just talking to anybody.
And then Tay, who's Justin Bieber's A&R, was like, we're huge fans. And then Justin Bieber right away goes, hey guys, I did something on Essence. We can send it to see what you guys think. I hope you like it. And then he sent it. Then Wiz was like, hey guys, I was on a flight. I appreciate your love. Please send the vocals. I'll piece it in and send it back. I'll send back the arrangement. And then Wiz put 3 fire emojis. It was like, fire my brother. And then just the guy was like, this chat is like a love fest.
Hey.
So I'm pretty sure they're going to make more music.
Jamie was on the beach, dancing on the beach.
This guy made this thing quick.
Yeah, he did.
And he sent it back now.
He did. Yeah,
there's more.
He did. And I'll there were the other remixes to too.
There was the baby remix.
He hopped on it.
There was
the Wu-Tang Clan members, Ghostface Killah and Raekwon. They hopped on it. I've heard many other remixes, too.
Spanish versions.
Dope record. Record.
O2.
Wizkid sold out the O2
3 times
in 35 minutes.
3 times.
And he actually sold it out.
3 times.
He sold this shit out.
He sold 3 dates. So he did the first date. Yo. It sold in, I think, 18 minutes.
I can't wait for the concert.
I forget how many minutes. O2 Arena put out the tweet that he was joining the likes of.
And this time they actually acknowledged.
They acknowledged it. No, the first one. So I think it was, I'm trying to get, I think Spice Girls was like one of the, all right, there we go. Wizkid sells out O2 Arena in 12 minutes. Beyonce, Rihanna, plus other stars have done it. So
yeah,
12 minutes. The first date he announced was sold out in 12 minutes. Then people kept saying Wizkid, you need to put out another date, right? Mm-hmm. So he puts out another date and it gets sold out in minutes. I think this was even quicker than 12 minutes. and then the same day he announced a third date.
I've been seeing people on Clubhouse complaining that how can we get to these concerts?
Like, he announces a third date and he sells out again.
Dude, you know we can resell our whiskey tickets for a lot of money. I'm not gonna do it. Hell no.
The experience is worth more than the money that I'll
get
from it.
Man, this is the concert of the summer. I can't wait to see this.
It showed out.
That's my sister.
35 minutes. The two dates. In one day.
Yeah, that's huge.
It's one thing for Wizkid. I've done O2 Arena before with some other supporting act when he was the headliner. And I don't know if they sold out. Some people say they sold out, but they sold out not at full capacity. Because, you know, there are different types of sales sold out.
Yeah.
Arenas, you can pay for, if an arena is 20,000, you can pay for 15,000. So they won't release all seats to you. They'll release only 15,000. You can sell out 15,000. In fact, you can sell out 500 tickets, but it's only 500 your capacity you have. So they claimed it wasn't fully sold out like that, but it was sold out at the reduced price. Or that was the rumor going around. And then they had supporting acts. The next year, Davido did O2 by himself, or him and his DMW, HKM people at the time.
He sold it
sold out too. But again, the same thing was going around claiming it wasn't probably full capacity. I don't know.
Even Brenner did a
now,
show.
Now, Brenner did a show and sold out.
But it wasn't really sold out.
It wasn't really sold out again.
Because I saw the stadium and there were empty seats.
Yeah, they were empty, exactly. And then there were also something I think we were saying, like at some point, there were like free tickets for some people. I don't care if they were free tickets, but it seemed like it wasn't at full capacity.
Yeah.
But they were sold out nonetheless. That's the rumor. I've not been
so sold out is different from sold out.
Sold out is different from sold out.
There's the different levels of sold out.
But look at this. There are only three people that have been able to do O2 headlining.
Tell them.
Wiz, Davido, Brenner. But Wiz has now done it in a year, in this year, in a space of how many months? Because two shows are in December. I think one is in like November or October. In space of less than 3 months, he sold out three times. He's going to perform at the O2 three times. You know, the only people that get to do stuff like that are people like Drake, Beyonce, and the likes.
Yeah.
And which is why I would conclude by saying Wizkid is the greatest of all time when it comes to Afrobeat music.
Let's talk about it. Let's say some people are saying Fela.
Bro,
no.
Take sentiment away.
Look,
from
and I love Fella. Fella will always be to me the greatest.
Fella
you know,
is
like
the most
activist
yes.
Slash
I think,
artist.
I think talented.
But in terms of doing this music business
in today's world,
doing this music business, come
you
on,
you gotta take it out. It's just what it is.
He's a goat.
It's like
he's the goat.
It is. He's the great. You know, and
greatest. Greatest Nigerian to ever do it on the world stage.
Things will happen in the future. Technology, yes. You know, the arguments I've heard is that, well, technology played a part. Well,
yeah.
It's not his fault that technology plays a part.
We talked about this.
If that's the case, then we need to be dismissing any new record. Say, okay, well, even look at running. We say Usain Bolt is the fastest man. Well, Usain Bolt had technology to help him with his form. Usain had better diet, better things that some other people in the past didn't have. So are you going to now take it away and say, well,
you can't put anything on technology.
It's just what it is. It's part of life. But no, Fela never sold out O2 three times.
Being consumed by
far more people. This does not mean that, because this is what people hear when you say Whiskey is great of all time over Fela. Is you are saying Fela is trash? Hell no.
Fela's
influence birthed. You can even see it in Brenner. You can see it in Wiz.
I think it gave us Afrobeats.
I think, yes, it gave us Afrobeats.
It birthed an entire genre.
The S, that's what they always say.
Yeah.
The beats is not like the Afro pop, the Afro fusion. So what it did was Fela would always be in the Hall of Fame of Afro
always.
Beats because he
always.
Started the... But it's not about... Again, I can start a movement, but someone else can take that baton. And run further
and take it to the next level. That's all it is.
And that's what it is. Wizkid has taken that baton from Fela and taken it to the next level. And thus, right now, making him the greatest of all time.
Plus, he still has a number one record. Wizkid still has a number one record. Yes. Let's keep it a buck. I'm still mad Drake didn't release that video.
Wonders. Oh my
God. I'm still freaking pissed.
Until someone else takes that baton from. And then the funny thing about it is, like, we can praise him. Because a lot, the even everyone who argues with me that Fela is the greatest of all time. Okay, based on what? What are you basing on? Record sales with shows with influence with. Oh, now they're telling me activism. Okay, so
but that's not really music.
Activism now.
That's different.
If we're talking about activists, yes, I don't think there's been any greater activist out of Nigeria than Fela, because Fela put it in his music and he really put himself out there, you know.
Yeah.
But as far as where we keep it a buck to music, Fela is
Wizkid
the father.
Wizkid has surpassed Fela.
Yes, in terms of
period.
But Fela is
we're
the father.
We're here, smiling.
He's the
father. Podcast.
He's the father of Afrobeat.
He is.
Without him, there will be no Afrobeat.
There will be no Afrobeat.
But that doesn't mean that you cannot be better than your father.
Yes,
that's the thing people don't always understand. We strive to be better than
Baba.
Our father.
He's done Wiz to the
he's
world.
Done it. He's done, it. And he's not.
We're proud of you,
bro. And honestly, Fireboy tweeted something about Wizkid. He said,
"We need to move on from this.
We
have a bunch of other stuff
bro,
to
bro,
hit.
Like, no, as in, we always spoke about these things since, and I've argued about these things with people. And, you know, but
he's
he,
the GOAT.
He tweeted,
he
so,
is
I wish
the
I could
GOAT.
See. It's okay. When I find it, I'll read it to you.
Let's move on to some other news, man. Let's take a complete 180 here. Wande Cole, another Afrobeat GOAT. Did you hear about the feature he's got with T-Pain?
Yeah,
I'm going to play it really quickly.
Yeah.
1 second. And this record sounds dope, man. It's already sounding dope. But check this record out. And I haven't heard Wande's part yet.
Wande. No, it's not there yet. But okay, sorry. Pause it before it starts. This was Fireboy's tweet. Listen,
Yeah.
We're witnessing greatness here. I'm so inspired at Wizkid Ayo. And you put a goat next to it.
Oh, yeah.
That's it.
Oh, yeah.
Be appreciative of it.
This is the new.
Yeah, I'm excited for this.
I'm excited. Yeah, I can't wait. Because, first of all, they sonically, they sound very alike.
They look alike.
they sound very alike sonically.
You know, they look alike. They both dance.
They do.
Both chubby guys that dance.
They do. And.
But it sounded like
everyone was excited about this. Everyone saw T-Pain Wande Cole feature. What? Mm-hmm. But this is.
It
this,
looks like it's T-Pain that is.
This is what we're and you know.
I think somebody gave T-Pain Wande a song, and then he did something.
And then
on
he
it,
did something on it.
And he's trying to get it.
And real. This is Wande Cole is someone that.
Wande is someone that's talented.
I don't think we're giving him enough of his flowers.
No, we. I think people have people. So, again, Wande falls.
Insiders, we do. But I don't think people like you because we see people like the Burners and the Wizkids up there. They don't realize that some of the people that have paved the way for them.
But
Wande
again,
Cole,
and it's back to what I was saying earlier. It's not about just talent anymore. Wande is one of the most talented Nigerian artists there is, or African artist. He is. But something has just not worked out. Like honestly, I think maybe the Mohits breakup was the thing. I think maybe between the Mohits breakup, because none of the people from Mohits blew. The only person that has actually been able to steady herself was Tiwa. Well, Tiwa wasn't even in Mohits.
Yeah.
She was in Mavens.
Yeah.
But Mohits, none of the people from Mohits era.
I mean, Dibanj blew.
Dibanj, after Mohits' career, was never the same.
Yeah.
Even though he's been able to drop out music, it's just never been the same. Wande was never the same. Dr. Sid, none of them were ever the same. And I think maybe if Wande had, I don't know, something just happened with Wande, because in Mohits, that their CV album, when you listen to Wande's verses or Wande's Mushi to Mohits album, I'm expecting Wande to be on a Wizkid level.
Wande was penning.
And him and Wizkid are friends.
Wande was writing songs.
Yes,
for
the bands. I expect Wande to be on a Wizkid level today. But it's just life. This is how life is. So it's not only about talent. Back to that guy that was tweeting about voice.
Sometimes it's luck too.
That's what I say. It's timing, it's luck, it's ethic. That's why I said it's not just favor over labor, it's favor and labor. It's everything together.
There's a lot that goes into it. But check this out, man. This is the T-Pain Wande Cole.
I'll
collabo
one this verse on this thing
that's on the horizon. I can't wait for it, man, because this is like exciting What's music that? Here
oh my God, you're gonna love this. You're gonna I need to talk back in the days.
It's Kelpie that produced it.
Necessary if you're too scary. You know the streets get away from you if you let it. Your best friend to turn up is too
heavy. I can't wait to hear one this part.
It could be the beginning, the end of this video. You hear the video one day.
Trust me, I know the street.
That's one day. Bro, I don't blame you. Where is that? This is fire, man. This is going to be great. This is going crazy.
Oh my God!
That's the reaction. Do you know what it is when an artist creates music and that's his reaction? You know it's going to be fun. Yeah. So then the artist like T-Pain is talented.
Yeah.
It's for you know, but that's not T-Pain's first delve into.
He's had I remember hearing
remix featuring Two-Face on Two-Face album.
Yeah, I remember hearing some other Afrobeat tracks he's that had, he's been on.
He's had with Freestyle. Is it with Freestyle? The guy that used to be in Tribesman. A few.
Let's pivot to Burna's new record. What did you think about that
questions,
record?
Questions, but no get the answer. Yeah.
Do you want to do a quick reaction? We're not going to play the whole thing.
I think it's not a bad song. It's not a hit song. I like it with Don Jazzy.
It's a nice record. It's a nice record.
It really has 5 million views.
Interesting
video. Yeah. I think I like it. It's not a hit. You know, it's not a but not every song artists drop have to be hits. You know what I mean?
This one, what is it?
I like the song. Like it's not a Dangote or on the low or give Burna Boy over every other Afrobeat, well, Nigerian artist is he knows how to perform.
He does. He's a great performer.
He's an amazing performer.
Great performer.
Like he puts in so much thought process. He doesn't just walk across the stage and jump or like vibe, like he puts on, like, and he composes music, not compose, he creates. Mm-hmm. So it's like, okay, they sit down and they have like a music creator. Oh,
by the way, what's your mid song?
Oh, they have like, you know, they have somebody like a compose, they don't, it's not just, oh, I want to play this song, that song, that song, that song. There's like different transition phases into how songs fade into one song to another song to another song. We're going to stop. This one's going to just be instrumentals of live band. And you know, it's very amazing. It's an experience, which is what you actually pay money for. Yeah. Because if I want to be hearing you scream or shout or hearing you just stay on the stage and put microphone in for us to sing, then I could have done that in my house by listening to it on my radio.
And I definitely don't want to be paying for me to be singing.
For me to be singing your own song. You can have moments where you want to hear the crowd harmonize, though, but not that the whole show is with us.
That was concert.
I'm glad I got those tickets.
It's going to be lit.
I'm going to email there because they have not sent me the tickets. They sent it to me.
It's going to be lit.
Call them tomorrow. Send the tickets.
It's going to be lit. What other records came out? Oh, your boy, our boy,
Buju.
Oxlade.
Buju, Peru remix. Oh, Buju.
Oh, Peru. Para. I don't have audio mark on here.
Just go to YouTube. It's on YouTube. It's all on right. His verse. Buju.
So,
yeah, I'll tell you, man.
We already played the Peru song.
Oh, right? Yeah, but this one, just do Buju. It's only Buju's part.
And Buju did a cover of this track, and this shit went. Like this guy went. He went hard. No. It's not that one.
Not this one. Go back. That's the whole song. It's that one. The second one. No. It's literally. I'll tell you. I'll give it to you. I have it on the playlist. There it is. Yeah.
Which one?
That one with the two of them in there. Yeah. Get Peru done it by.
It's your fault if you don't know me. I be bad boy, Ellen, you confirm me. I'm in Victoria, Island charming. And me and your teacher, Mari. Won't want me, won't want me. But I'm out here looking for money. I'm there, my girl, who alone show me. And this big shout out to my daddy. Man, I just got to London. And they're out here playing my song. Sleep on, who are you done? When my first project, they come. Buju, para. Buju, buju, para. Who is you? See my mind for the rapper. When you won't want me, when you won't want me, I'm in San Francisco, Jami. When you won't want me, when you won't want me, I just flew in from Miami. Beru, para. Beru, para. I'm loose. Even better.
That's Buju, another person that we've been telling you to watch out for.
He's on Wizkid's mood.
He's on Wizkid's mood, which is on the
deluxe album.
Deluxe album, right? You want me to play it?
Yes. Guy.
That's another correct
jam. Guy.
That's another correct jam.
Bro. Nah, I'm happy. At all of used to tweet at like used to abuse Whiskey, Davido, brother. It didn't like anybody.
But you know that's what happens when you have a chip in your shoulder. You kind of feel some resentment when everyone else is
years ago, though. Years ago,
when everyone else is getting on the shine.
You know, Whiskey FC don't want him there. Actually, Whiskey FC are not happy with the fact that Whiskey, because they feel like, you know, why are you
calling him out?
Obviously, like Whiz obviously doesn't care about those tweets and probably sees it as, bro, this was years ago, man. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, but. The guy was so happy when, like, you know the way artists are happy that they were on Drake's album? That's how happy this guy was that he was on Wiz's album.
Yeah.
Like, you know that line in Peru where it says, Eleni, you'll confirm me? He was referring to Wiz because when Wizkid put the track list, he tweeted that line, like, you know, like, almost. So I think he was probably referring to Wiz, you know, or he used it for Wiz. But, like, he's really, like, he's happy, man. I'm happy for the guy,
dope,
too.
Dope.
Like, we can do break song.
You ready for the break song, or you want to get into the Tiwa records too? She had this one record that everyone,
somebody's song,
heartbroken single Nigeria girls love. Somebody's song.
The girls that
they said were crying.
The girls that the CLBs have dealt with. But no, before we get there, let's do Oxlade middle song. But Oxlade dropped an album.
He did,
but I won't use a middle song from the album. But we can, because we're gonna play.
I couldn't find the album for some reason on.
It's
on Spotify. Someone else's album,
Tonic Music and Oxlade. So look for Tonic Music.
Okay, so that's what it was. It's Tonic Music, because I couldn't find it. I was trying to find it earlier.
Which is TONIQ. But before you do that, middle song is we're gonna take it to our Ghanaians real quick. It's
Tonic. So which one should I do?
Music song. No, do Non Living Thing. Sarkodi featuring Oxlade. That way it's best of both worlds. So Sarkodi dropped his new album titled No Pressure, and it's actually pretty dope. He has Wale in there, Kwesi Ato, he has Vic Mensa, he has Giggs.
Vic Mensa is Ghanaian too, you know.
Oh yes.
Yeah. Well, his dad is Ghanaian. He represents Sha-Town. Nice. Chicago.
Yeah.
I thought we were gonna be forever. Woo! Not my home yet, but I was trying to make it better. Think I seven to my large GB, but find me up for Stella. I guess I didn't get the memo. Minim sissy in the bank, yes, I need emo. You always wanna make me feel like me and Bemo. Michelle, once I'm recording my first demo. 2007, I'm a falling my work, I would dream. And you think you're soon, you're now, it's like a dream. Obey your BB cry, this is too extreme. Yes. And you wait, guess how many people go stream? Cause a lot of niggas know exactly what I'm talking about. Yeah. It might be cheating, but Mema, it's not allowed. No. I swear to God, so maybe I was born faithful until the first female who suddenly broke a vow.
Woo. I feel like you gonna be my baby.
What else?
Yeah. But you don't follow, I like you, go, God, no. I feel like you make you be my honey. But you go say, I know if you have all your bills, yaro. I don't give up on oh, loving. Because without you, I know I'll be lovable. I don't give up on oh, wanting nobody. I don't know what I am again. I'm a non-living thing. No, no. I'm a non-living thing. Without you, I'm a non-living thing. Baby, I don't exist. I don't exist without you. I'm a non-living thing.
Beginning, I thought I was tripping. Yeah. But I mean, him said the time is ticking. Ah. And I could see that something was missing. Mama, we liberty. I never kept you in the kitchen. Cause superwoman and I believe in your vision.
What else?
Capri name and hope, but I was wishing.
Yeah.
See me yeah, because when I talk, you know they listen. Mini Bema, but you took over position. Sick of a large DP and I'm so with Jamini block. We moon you now, be see then a boy send your fraud. About the taco crammy pushy drug.
Yes.
Sika ye sika legitimate and also blood.
Yeah.
Now me free say we go right until the end. Then so all along you they pretend. I guess I lost a friend.
Yeah.
Thought I got it figured. There's a lot I need to learn.
Woo. Oh, Ima, why you do me so? I don't know what I do you. Why you do me so? Oh, oh, oh. Oh, Ima, why you do me so? I'ma eat it, pay me. It be like seven hard on they feel me. I dey feel it, it thing for my kidney. It dey shook me, need do for my penny. It dey pay me, yo, for my penny. I know if you do this, if any can me. I feel lost in my card, all my penny. I don't know what I am again, I'm a non-living thing. No, no, I don't know, no. I don't know what I feel for you. So no, see you mean a lot to me. Oh. Miami, come Miami, feeling my penny, baby. Oh, yeah, come Miami, I'm another baby.
Just since that's the
all right, we're back. So, yeah. That was Sarkodie featuring Oxlade.
Bidi bom bidi.
Bidi.
That's what he says.
I beg the bomb biggie.
It's
on. It's called Non Living Thing.
It's on his album. No
it's
Stress.
On the album No Stress.
Oxlade killed that.
People
song.
Love the album. People, I haven't heard the album. Yeah, I'm gonna admit.
I like the album.
But Oxlade also released an EP with someone else, but then like another.
I think Tonic Music is the name of a label. Is what I've been able to.
But the thing is, I haven't been able to find the album on Spotify. All I know is that there's this song called Ojuju. That's I kind of fucks
that's
with.
That's the lead single. So
I really I
the album is called Eclipse.
Tronic.
Yeah, Tronic, sorry. Tronic. Not Tonic, sorry, Tronic, my bad. You can click on Tronic Music there now. Yeah, it's Tronic, not Tonic, I know. So it's yeah, and it was produced by Kobolon, which is a very good DJ. He's the one that also produced the song that we just played right now. There we go. Tronic Music is an artist, not a label. There it is.
It's called Eclipse. And there's this one record on it that's really, really nice. It's like an EP But this one record called Ojuju. Yeah. I think Tronic Music is like a DJ.
Tronic Music is the name of a label too. So it's weird. It's weird.
Yeah, it's not under his Spotify.
No, it's not
under,
yes.
So it's not going to count on that. I mean, does it technically count on that? Oh, yeah. It will.
That's why Tems.
But this is Ojuju.
Over my list. Google on the trash.
It's like this love thing, girl, in our body. I am fed up of falling, I'm falling in. I gotta say, a lot of things come to play. I'm all for the matter, baby.
That's right.
To make money crazy, oh baby, I know me sense, but this is matter make me faint. This kind thing with the prince, to make money crazy, color. I'm afraid of falling in love again. I got scars, baby, and you know me pains. Me no one friend, me no one shed tears. Me a day try, cause you're making me senseless, giving me nightmares. Cause me, I need health care. Oh no, I don't know how everybody does it, cause it don't tire me. I don't know how everybody does it, cause it don't kill me.
Dope record, man. Dope record. Oxlade is another person that we said
Oxlade.
To watch out for. He's doing his thing.
Oxlade.
He's had quite a few really, really big features. Yeah, man. Someone to keep watching out for.
Bro, all of them. There's nobody I've mentioned that actually has flopped.
I think
the only person that hasn't really done as much was what's her name again?
Aria. We never,
no,
really
never, know Aria.
We never
no,
really Aria. Put Aria no, on. We were still trying Aria. To figure out Aria.
I like her song, you know.
She
new
did.
Song.
She did come out no, with an album though.
Yeah, yeah. I like the bloody
19 are dangerous.
What's the name of that song? Bloody Samaritan or something.
Bloody Samaritan.
No, the one the girl, this girl's sister, Niniola's sister.
I know who you're talking about.
Tenny.
Yeah. Okay.
Tenny is the only one I think we mentioned that never really.
But Tenny's big in Nigeria.
She's big, but I feel like I expected
she hasn't. She hasn't reached her potential.
Yes. I feel like these guys are now all coming out. Like, these guys are doing very well. Oxlade, Rema, Omale.
Your boy, yeah.
Like, bro, even the one that is fucking up, Bella Shmurda, they're all doing very Buju. Like, yeah. They're all like, bro, these people are having the top 10 songs, you know. Tenny
consistently.
I think Tenny had that in that early push.
Yeah.
But I think somehow she's not, because I don't think her album did that way. I don't think any of the songs on her album entered the.
I know that she only works with that one producer. Why?
That's a
Dr.
Boss
Dollar
now.
Or something.
That's the guy that owns her label now.
Oh, that's why. Interesting.
All right, go on what you were saying.
All right.
But she's still mad talented, though. I'm pretty
she
sure.
She is. Man. A lot of talent there. A lot of talent. And who knows, she can still reach those heights.
That's the beauty about it. Anyone can still
Yeah, get it, yeah. She has time. You know, me, I've told you why I feel like
I need to go back and limited. Look at other names.
I've told you why I feel like she's limited to an extent.
What? Because of the way she is?
Let's just keep it a buck. Yes, we like good music. We like good vocalists. But that packaging too plays a factor. And I'm not saying, to me, it doesn't matter as much. As long as you put out good music, to me, that's all that matters. But to the Nigerian audience, I think it plays a factor. That's why you like, see people like Tiwa Savage. They're still doing it.
You see like an
Ariastar trying to look very like, you know, sexualized.
For women.
Seductive.
Yeah, for women. It's a factor. Even her sister Nino Latu comes out with a very seductive manner.
It's a factor.
Honestly, it takes one person to
it does. To knock it does. Maybe it is Tenny.
Yeah.
She has that talent.
It does.
And one thing about Tenny, I'll tell you that when it comes to singing, that girl can sing her ass off. She can sing her butt off.
She just needs to. I don't know. She just needs to write hit song again. That's all.
But these other guys,
they're just so good that they don't even need like to have the number one. But they are having the number one song. But like, they just all their songs are just nice.
Yeah.
Yeah,
did you hear that "Understand" by Omalay?
Yes, now.
Ah,
you know, you know that Omalay was someone I grew came out since.
"Understand" grew on
Spotify
me.
Spotify did my Understand thing for me 2 years in a row. Omalay, I've been one of "Understand."
I was going to talk about Tiwa Savage. Tiwa Savage also has an EP out called "Water and Gary."
Yes, which I haven't listened to.
I listened to it today. She actually features Nas on the number one record.
I've only seen clips of Somebody's Son with Brandy.
But Somebody's Son is the one that has been making a lot of coverage.
It is because it has Brandy on there. Then
it has Brandy on there.
The video of her like hearing, I think, Brandy's verse for the first time was like, I think she was very like,
it was like
emotional.
A viral moment.
Viral moment. I think
so.
It was
so
on
this
the
is the song
itself.
That a lot of the single,
like I said, the ladies that the CLB,
single Nigerian ladies
that the CLBs have dealt with, the love boys.
Yeah, some people are saying that I was crying over this song. Lord. It made me cry. I like the song,
but you know
it's
what?
A nice record.
That's what I was about to say. Like,
it's a nice
even
record.
The clips I've heard. It's nice. I think I added it to one of my more mellow playlists to listen to. Not like my pop, Afro pop kind of.
Yeah. It's a nice record. But this is Somebody's Son featuring
Brandy.
See
what I can sing. So.
Check this out. So you know one of those songs that you played and you as a fan, as someone that listens to music, as someone that understands the story behind artists, you know, things, their personal life, things that they've gone through, the struggles that they've had. Immediately the song came out, it connected with people because we knew that Tiwa had gone through like certain things where it's like, you know, she's gone through certain heartbreaks.
Yeah, people
she's gone through certain disappointments.
People got emotional for her. And then even just the beef with the other girl.
Yeah.
What's her face? Can't remember. She's been through a lot, and then obviously, you know, the main one was like her son, like a baby daddy, T-Bills.
Yeah,
is it not T-Bills? Yeah, T-Bills. But also, I think it's a kind of song too where if you're going through any, like she said in the beginning of the song, this is going to be another heartbreak song. Heartbreak songs touch women.
They
a
do.
Lot.
They do.
A lot.
They do.
They get women a lot.
They do.
Like she's a smart song. She's like.
I mean, I connected with the song.
He gets there. She's like.
Like I could. I not. I'm not saying I could relate to it, but I understood.
You understood where she's coming
where
from.
Where she was coming from.
I heard. I heard. I just never played the full song, but I heard a lot of snippets where I was like, "Oh, I like this," because I kept seeing the video of her and
Brandy.
And then even that you could see like. I think Tiwa's also like going through like more even career-wise struggles, and you know we say it's not easy because
it's not.
We try to brand Tiwa as the African Beyonce,
yes,
the number one, but like
it comes with pressure.
Look at it; she has 1.376 million listeners. And I just said Temps has 12 million.
I know it took was a
Only
few songs.
Only took us a few songs. Do you get it? That thing itself can be like,
things can switch around.
It can,
very
it can
quickly.
Pain you to is like, I'm Tiwa, I'm an OG. So I think this song was very, like, from the bottom of her heart. She put, so when she heard the Brandy verse, I think she was either crying or very, she seemed very emotional to in the video I saw. So you can, it's a very like, and it's not a bad song.
Yeah, it's a good song.
So it's a good song.
Another thing about the Brandy collaboration is that Tiwa started out writing for songs for Brandy, very early on, before Tiwa Savage really hit it big. So to come back to and this full circle where Brandy is featuring on her song, you know, there's something really, really, really personal about the song that I can understand why she would feel so emotional about.
So, you know, kudos to her.
Yeah. I enjoy the song.
I haven't heard snippets of any other song on the album.
She had another record on there that featured Nas.
I'll check it out.
It was nice. It was a very mellow song. It's like an EP. It's like a five track record. It's called Water and Gary. But since we're talking about heartbreaks, man,
I think she needs to stick to this genre of music. But then problem is can you be successful in Nigeria with singing only songs
like ballads?
Yeah, because she's did a good job on this one.
Nigerians love the ballads too. Nigerians love two songs. People that can sing too.
But they only love to tweet about people that can sing. Yes. Because at the end of the day,
it's in the club.
It's in the club. They want to guess it. We cannot guess it to this.
So
exactly. But you're saying, speaking of heartbreak, what happened?
Speaking of heartbreak, man, did you hear about Annie Macaulay Idibia?
Annie Idibia. Annie Macaulay.
It's getting really messy. So, Annie Idibia came out online.
No, Paul Piscuato and his wife have split up.
Yeah, they split up.
Yeah.
Yeah. But Annie Idibia came out and she had this.
I think it's Annie.
Annie Idibia. Annie Macaulay Idibia.
Yeah. I think she
came out. Middle name. And she was having this. I don't want to say she was having a breakdown, but she was airing out her marital problems with Two-Face Idibia. Two-Face is a legend.
I never support that child on social media because internet never forgets.
Yes. It never forgets. And so the way I see it is that if you really are working to resolve things, the internet is the last place you should put it on.
And if you're not, even if you're not still, the internet is not. Internet should not be saying anything dirty about you because they would not forget.
No, they won't.
Because if you guys end up working things back,
they'll not be looking at you. That
you know you that was saying
the internet
this,
never forgets.
Never forgets. They always are very.
It never forgets.
They always bring it back and say, "You know, you did you not say that? Why did you? Yeah, so."
So this was the first post that she put up, I believe. She said Annie Idibia
blind Two-Face's brother.
Now you no, it was her brother. It was actually her brother that came out.
Annie replies Two-Face's brother.
That's no, what I'm trying to find the original post that she put up. Oh, it was Two-Face's brother.
Yeah.
But you know, throughout the whole thing, Two-Face hasn't said anything. Like she hasn't said anything.
Because Two-Face I would not expect him to go on tweet or post on social media.
Yeah, he ain't on that time. Mm-mm. He's not on that time at all. I wish I could find the original post. It was the original post that had her where she had the I want to just point it out because I felt like she was kind of crying for help in the post.
So what's she saying? Two-Face, what did he do to her?
Basically she was alleging. It's all allegedly. We don't, you know, we don't know anything. It's all alleged. But she was alleging that Two-Face was hanging out with his other baby mama. I forgot her name. But he's the one that he has three kids with. And the thing about it is, Two-Face has had kids within the relationship with Annie Idibia. So it's almost like a polygamous relationship. Like it's at least everyone just assumed that it was some kind of arrangement where it was like Two-Face has his baby mother, he still hangs out with. But now she's coming out and she is complaining about the fact that Two-Face is spending time with his baby mother and his children with his other baby mother, and they're spending time in the same room, in the same hotel or whatever. Let me see if I can find it here. I thought I had it queued up, but I had the wrong one queued up.
Baby mama drama.
It's a lot of baby mama drama. Yeah. Idibia family saga. Divorce imminent as actress removes Idibia from her IG bio. But that wasn't the original post. The original post that sparked it up. Yeah, finally found it. Shh. All right. I am a patient woman. I am not a something innocent. Your family never loved from the beginning. No matter how hard I tried, I was never worthy to them. I have made so many sacrifices for you and all your children. God knows I have tried. That wasn't the original post either. Sorry, got that wrong again. Instablog has so many posts that it's hard for you to find the original one. You know what?
Like 1,000 people.
I'll insert it later. Like, but 1,000 posts. Basically, she was alluding to the fact that Two-Face was still hanging out with his baby moms. The thing about it is that everyone assumed that Two-Face was always with his baby moms. This was someone that he was with before they got married. He had kids with before they got married. And my question to you is, polygamy in Nigeria, obviously we all know it gets messy. Is this something that, are we past this phase of people expecting people to be polygamous? Or is this something that we have evolved past? What's your take on it? I'm curious.
I mean, but she knew what she was getting herself into now. She wasn't the first woman he was dating.
No, she wasn't.
I mean, I don't know what arrangement they have. I don't know what
we don't know. That's the thing.
I don't know.
This is the first time that she's come out to air out her grievances.
But I know, wasn't she one time like cool with the lady, the other baby mama?
Yeah, we all thought they were all cool.
Posted like some almost like what Will Smith was doing at one point. So
yeah, blended family.
Blended family. So we never really know. Nah, she accusing him of cheating? Doesn't sound like she is.
She's accusing. She's implying. Possibility. She's implying that he is cheating on her with his baby mama, and people are confused. Like, wait, he was having kids while he was with you. He has kids in the middle of his other kids with Anne. Do you understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, kid had Annie had a kid with Two-Face. Two-Face had another kid with the other girl, with the other lady. Now, obviously, this is before they got married. But now they got married, and maybe her expectation was that now that we've got married, you shouldn't be messing around with another with your baby mama, which is strange to us. But it's gotten really messy. Annie, Dibia's brother, has gotten into it. He's cursing out Two-Face's mom. Two-Face's brother, too, seems to have gotten into it. It's really, really messy.
That's
we don't really know.
When you take social media, everyone just starts.
That's the thing. We don't really know what really happened. And honestly, I don't like to get into it. I'm not going to assume like I know. I'm not here to get into all this gossip. I just wanted to kind of get your take on what you thought about like the idea of polygamy in Nigerian
whatever
society.
You know, whatever you sign up for, deal with it, is what I'm saying. And Nigerians polygamous, they're still doing it now. You can have more than one. It seems like stress.
It seems like a lot. Like a lot of headache. I don't know how he's been able to deal with it for this long.
To be dating two women.
Okay, this is her again. I need
or,
to be,
or have kid, even having kids.
Maybe y'all don't know. Your brother is tired. Everyone is trying to suck him dry because you have a successful brother. Now that won't make you lazy, sad, living under my roof and coming here to insult me and my mother. He has 7 kids, yet you all want to suck him dry. If trying to protect my husband and the levels of kids makes me something, do be it. I am evil then. I don't know. It's messy. But hey, I don't know. I just thought it was, this is Two-Face is an Afrobeat legend. I thought it was worth at least mentioning that he's going through some kind of baby mama drama. I wish him the best. I hope he's able to get through it. See this one, he's commenting. This your boy. Your boy.
He always wants to insert himself in everything, man.
He's annoying. I'm not even gonna mention his name. You're gonna see his picture there, but I'm not gonna mention his name. He's just an annoying
guy. You know, there are some people that just anything. I don't know, man. Just every and anything they just want to insert themselves in. Like, and it's not that they're like talking about it. Like, you can be reporting something or talking. It's like they have a very strong opinion about everything. You know, it's like
everything.
I have a take. And it's like, you know,
we don't give a shit.
Yeah, like you can just comment like everyone else or just pass your own sinawao, but like it's almost like there's always has to be a hot take about everything. Like,
Sometimes we just don't know. Like for this Two-Face stuff, I don't know enough.
I don't know. Like, and Two-Face, I just know that
something is going on.
I can't really say more than Two-Face has done.
See, I always respect the person, that doesn't come out on it. That's the person that I prefer to defer to. The person that doesn't come out. But moving on, let's move on to something else. I do want to talk about this Kanye Drake beef. I mean, I understand we talk about Afrobeat here, but this is a very, very huge moment in music industry, period. Have you been following this saga?
Oh yeah, I saw that Kanye dropped Drake's album. Address.
Kanye dropped Drake's Address. So I
did push Ati to the group chat.
Yes. He put the picture of Joker there. But not only that, Drake put out a diss record. This was before Kanye even dropped his album. Drake put out a diss record with on the Tribute Red's album.
Yeah.
There's been a lot of back and forth. At some point, it appeared like Kanye was delaying his record.
He was.
So that he could mess with Drake's release date.
He was.
But you know what happened?
Somebody got tired of
it. I think the Universal Music CEO or whoever, yeah, the head, they were like, fuck this. We're not going to fuck with our money.
Yeah, and because Kanye has been doing how many stadium freaking tours?
For like 7 weeks. He was supposed to have dropped this album in July. He kept postponing it. I think the record label was like, F this, man. Like, we cannot afford to let you step on Drake's toes, on Drake's release date. Because Drake, the week before, Drake announced that his album was coming out September 3rd. Mm-hmm. Certified Lover Boy. Mm-hmm. And they were like, nah, man, we're not gonna let these two coincide, because there's only so much people can listen to within a weekend. So I think they forced Kanye's album to come out. Kanye was pissed. Kanye was like, this wasn't supposed to happen. I think they're messing with each other. I do feel like Drake has been airing out a lot of his concerns on all these diss records. Scorpion, a lot of it was about Kanye. He was coming at Kanye. This album, did you get a chance to listen to Certified Lover Boy?
Not everything.
But
the song with Future.
There was Too Sexy.
Too Sexy. There was the one where he was like, she's a lesbian, me too.
Girls Want Girls. That's my joint. Let me play Cuba. I love that joint.
That's my jam.
Girls Want Girls, have fun. Girl. This one was with little baby.
The TSU was also not bad.
That's my joint too. That's my joint too. But yeah, the most popular song of the album right now is Girls Want Girls. I'm gonna play it.
Oh, wow, wow, wow. Hey. Staring at your dress cause it's see-through. Yeah, talking all the shit that you done been through. Yeah, say that you a lesbian, girl, me too. Hey, girls want girls where I'm from, right? Well, yeah, girls want girls, where, yeah, girls want girls where I'm from, yeah, girls want girls, hey, well, girls want girls where I'm from, hey. Can I play a player, baby? I grew up with Dre and Faze. I done seen the realest ones come and leave a crazy way. Had to take my spot, it wasn't something they just gave away. Sorry to all my fans, they might have called me on a crazy day. Fuck you niggas thinking trying to block me on a fadeaway. I've been on this shit, I only vibe with a payday. Say you go that way, I guess we both go the same way. Girls want girls where I'm from. Yeah, yeah, where we both from, hey. And you just got to Miami, need hotel rooms. Niggas told you that they love you, but they fell through. So you shot in 42, cause you, hey. And you throwing on that dress, cause it's see-through. Yeah, talking all the shit that you done been through. Yeah, texting me and say I need to see you. I don't know. I might come, I might go, I don't know. I might come, I might go, I don't know. Staring at your dress cause it's see-through. Yeah, talking all the shit that you done been through. Yeah, say that you a lesbian, girl, me too. Hey, girls want girls where I'm from. Yeah, well, girls want girls where I'm from.
Girls want girls where I'm from. Girls want girls where I'm
my
from.
My girl got a girlfriend. Ain't trying to be out of shape. What's the elbow on them curls? Then them gym don't work, get surgery. I'll pay for that, my courtesy. Can't imagine no bitch curving me. I put in that work overly. I handle business. And I got two pretty bitches. Keep them up on fleek. They got matching beans and matching AP. Now they can really call each other twins. I'm cool with all the owners. They love me. So they gon' let us in and bring all of your peers and look better with more people. We got 1942 Casamigos. It's getting heated. They gotta follow us in the Uber. My car filled up with shooters. It be lights, camera, action when you with us. It's a movie. I don't try my.
Yeah, that was Girls Want Girls featuring Lil Baby off the Certified Lover Boy album Drake recently dropped. Yeah, man. So, yeah, the Kanye Drake saga, I don't know what's going on. Here is my take on both albums. I love both albums. I actually genuinely do.
So, if you don't listen to the album in 5 minutes and say one is better than the other,
you see those ones.
They're going to re-listen to it.
There was someone that, within 1 hour of CLB dropping, they were like, this is the greatest album ever. I'm like,
relax.
In 1 hour.
Listen to it.
The thing is,
go to the gym, listen to it while you're walking out, listen to it in the car, listen to it on the walk.
I have had time to listen to the Donda album. It's experimental. There's a lot of like weird tracks on it that's starting to grow on me. So right now I'm enjoying the Donda album.
Jill was a good track.
I love Jill. He put Jay-Z on the album. That was a huge moment in hip hop, period.
I think he said there's a song that the label left out or something.
So he had a record with Andre 3000.
Mm-hmm.
And Andre 3000, for those that don't know, is like one of the most respected rappers in hip hop, period.
When he's not going around playing.
Plays. Hey! No,
there's one instrument. So he's always. This one, he's always doing the most mundane.
Yeah,
random.
He's a very, very weird, artsy rapper. Yeah. But he hasn't recorded a track. In fact, he came out and he said he retired from hip hop because he was tired of hip hop. But he recorded this beautiful track with Kanye. And in the middle of this Kanye Drake beef, Drake went to release, I guess Drake got an advanced copy of the record and went to release this single that was supposed to be on the Donda album. Mm-hmm. Kanye's album, and people loved the record, and people were confused, like, how wouldn't he put this record on the album? And then, you know, Andre had put out a statement because Andre 3000 was like, I didn't even know that this was a diss record. I thought this was about Donda, Kanye's mom, and he was talking about his mom because he lost his mom and his dad. So that whole thing played out. It's been very messy. These two rappers are starting to like pull other great artists into their beef. It's getting kind of ridiculous. You know, I think they're too grown for this shit.
No, but you know what?
Shit.
I'm here for it because I think, and Kanye stands might hate this. I think Kanye wants to be a bully, but he can dish it out and can't take it back.
You think so?
I think so. I've seen watch Kanye, he'll soon go on his mental breakdown stuff. We've seen him do it so many times. No, we've seen when things don't go Kanye's way, he thinks the world is against him, you know, and people are doing shit to him intentionally. Like, you know, yes, you guys are beefing, but you dropped that nigga's address. Now, sure, it might be public knowledge.
Most people know where Drake lives.
Know where he lives, Toronto. Yeah. But still, what people are not in Toronto, did you know where Drake lived?
Yeah, it's a very, very not been, antagonistic
yeah, you might have
way
not
of
been,
approaching
you beef. Might have not known that you could have easily found his address, or you might have not been interested in finding his address. Yeah.
Especially
then,
when you have so many followers.
But then now everyone knows where his address is.
It's irresponsible when you have so many followers that, especially like all these fanboys that are crazy about you.
Yeah, crazy.
Are you trying to tell them to go to Drake's
exactly
house?
Now, sure, maybe Drake stands and Drake groupies know where Drake lives, but maybe your fans that I've never thought about.
You don't know. You don't want to bring that energy.
And now you've brought that energy.
It was like irresponsible. He
should
have
done irresponsible,
that.
You know. So you're starting to get like very personal.
He shouldn't have done that.
When you had the whole thing with Pusha T, you brought his kid into this whole thing. So
Kanye didn't bring it. Pusha T.
Kanye was involved in that.
But apparently Kanye was the one that went to go and spill the beans.
Yeah, he was involved in that. So, you know, you've done so. Now, if someone decides, and then you need to see that obviously Drake is a bigger artist because someone in your label is not happy with you and they're not trying to mess up Drake's bag.
They leaked that track
because Drake wasn't there when he recorded it, so someone must have sent it to him. So
and then one of Kanye's ghostwriters, Consequence, came out. I was like, we're gonna find out who leaked the track.
Probably was him. You know, who knows?
I was like, so it's you, nigga, it's you, the first person that talks.
But you know, at the end of the day, Drake, at that point, you're going to be petty too.
Yeah.
So you do what you got to do. And
Drake,
yes,
Drake took shots at Kanye.
He took shots at Kanye on the album. I think Kanye should have just taken his shots peacefully. I think if you're going to, also, if you're going to diss somebody on a track and feature somebody else, I think she let that person know.
That, hey, he didn't let him know. And Andre 3000 was like,
because here's what's going to happen.
I made this about my mom and dad that have died.
Because you know what Kanye probably trying to do? He's trying to create more enemies for Drake.
For Drake.
So Drake would be like, oh, Andre, so for you Drake. Went on there, you did this, and then Drake will now retaliate, yeah. And then now you have
but
more
then,
people.
But then Drake released the record, and on in the caption, he said waste removal. And most people that heard the record was like, no, this is actually a fire track. Yeah, so we've been waiting to hear for Andre 3000. I think it's getting a little bit too messy. I think they're too grown for this shit.
I think so too.
They have kids.
Yeah, they're too, you know, grown. But if you go low, I go low too. So,
we're about to wrap up very soon. Any other thoughts, man? Just in the last, we haven't talked in so long, man. Anything else going on with you?
With me?
Yeah.
I don't like sharing things on the podcast.
Yeah, like, I know you don't.
Nah, I do okay, man.
You good? I do. Okay, but how about like just in terms of current events? Anything else that you want
to? I'm trying to see what else has happened. Oh, RIP to what's his face?
Some people have died. Okay.
No, the guy from The Wire.
Yes, Omar.
Omar from The Wire.
Omar from The Wire.
Michael K. Williams. Supposedly drug overdose.
Oh, he was?
Supposedly, that's what I read.
Oh, man, he was only 54 years old, apparently.
Yeah,
rest in peace.
RIP to him.
Rest in peace.
RIP to the lives lost in Afghanistan.
Oh yeah,
there's,
man,
a lot has been going on.
It's been messy in Afghanistan.
Yeah, in the world.
It's been messy in Afghanistan.
What else has been going on? There's a lot going on. I can't remember anything.
Any COVID updates for you?
COVID.
Dude, I went to Florida.
Look,
they don't give a shit. We went to a hookah bar. You know where we got there? We're asking now, do we have to wear masks? The guy said, hell no. The guy was, he looked offended. Like, what are we talking about?
Where did that happen?
Florida don't give a shit, though. They don't give a shit about COVID.
That's like Texas, too.
They don't give a crap about COVID. I don't really have anything else to, man. I think this was like a music episode that we really got into. A lot of tracks. I'm going to have all these tracks, the title of these tracks in the description. You know, you can check them out whenever you want to. As always, don't forget to please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Search for The Smiling Sufferer. Smiling Sufferer. Search for us there. We're on Instagram, Smiling_Sufferer. We're on Facebook, Smiling Sufferer. Search for us there. Follow us, please. Comment, like, subscribe. And we are on Twitter. We also post on Twitter. It's called @SmilingPod on Twitter. Check that out too. And outside of that, I don't really have much. I don't think we really have a smiler or sufferer of the week, do we? Do you?
Smiler of the week has to be Wizkid and Tems, man.
Yeah.
The two of them are smiling individually and
the person taking L's this week.
I don't know anyone taking L's really. Maybe
I don't know. I don't know that many people either.
Maybe this week. Arsenal fans. Last week,
football
is coming back on Saturday.
Arsenal
so,
fans. Yeah, man, they're
can't
going
think
through
of
it.
Anybody that is like
Arteta, for sure.
I can't think of anyone that is really like
Arteta. Is
I
suffering
guess
right
maybe
now.
I don't know.
Mikel Arteta.
In music wise, the industry within Drake, the beef, I guess between Drake.
No, but they're both taking W's now.
They are. I think that beef does need to stop, though.
It's they're too grown for that shit.
And especially when that happened with Andre, like you're gonna have
like other, don't drag another
other,
legend
other
into
other
this
legends
stuff.
Who are going
like
to
don't
be
drag other people into
a
this
little
shit.
Wary about, you know,
about doing features with
doing
them.
Features with them.
There are a lot of people that are pissed that.
But look at
left
Jay-Z,
left
man.
Off.
Jay-Z was on both albums.
There were a bunch of people on both albums. Lil Durk
yeah.
was on both albums. Travis Scott was on both albums. Kid Cudi,
like, bro, let me just get my bag, man.
There was a bunch of people on both albums. Yeah, they're like, Jay, man, we're gonna get. But and both albums have been really successful.
I like
Kanye came out with like, I think his first week is supposed to, he's been over 300,000 albums. Drake is supposed to even double that. So they're both doing, yeah. Drake is projected to do over 600,000.
Well, so also people are like, I don't always get this thing. So like, people, Drake is the greatest.
He's the GOAT.
When it comes to American, he's the GOAT.
We'll do it on another episode. Yeah, I'll break down
so
why.
So when
I
start seeing all the whole, Kendrick Lamar's album is coming, J. Cole's album, I'm like, I understand your stance. I understand, like, you want this, like, real down to earth. But this guy told you that CLB, he named an album Certified Lover Boy. What were you expecting?
Did you see the album cover?
Do you get the album cover?
Pregnant emojis.
The description of the album on Apple Music is a combination of toxic masculinity and acceptance of truth, which is inevitable, heartbreaking. And you are trying to compare Kendrick's album. This guy knows what he's doing. It's not he just told you the kind of album he wants to drop, and you are saying, "Oh, this album is whack."
Drizzy Drake,
Kendrick is going to come with bars.
Drizzy Drake,
doesn't want to drop bars. I listened to the music video, "Too Sexy," when him. Future
Young Thug. Young Thug and the basketball player.
Kawhi. Looking like Boys to Men. Yeah, like you get this reminds me of when he did that album that had you used to call me on myself. He knew what he was doing.
He knows how to make memes.
He know this album is having niggas and women tweeting lyrics from, he knew what he wanted to do. So don't come and be thinking.
He's a goat.
He knows what he was trying to do.
I will break down
Drake's album cover alone. I don't want to hear anything about Kendrick, anybody else. Drake's album cover alone has everybody, IBM doing their cover, Adobe doing a cover. Who else has that impact?
I know. He has huge impact.
He has huge impact. It's not about the bars anymore. It's a collective for him.
I do have my critique of the album. I do feel like the album is...
There were some lazy parts in the album.
It's a bit lazy.
Yeah, there were lazy parts, obviously.
Like, a lot of the songs were like songs that he has done before. Yes. He just rechanged.
Yeah, and they're lazy parts.
But it's still a moment.
It's still a moment.
He knows how to...
It's not a perfect album.
He knows how to create theater.
He delivered what he wanted to deliver.
That's what it is.
So, if you're looking for a hardcore rap album, this is not the album for it.
No, man.
You know, go listen to your J. Cole's and your Drake's, or go listen to your old Drake's.
Drake had some hardcore rapping on there. He had the 7 a.m. in Bridal Way or something.
And man, Drake loves Houston.
He does.
He loves Houston strippers.
He loves Houston strippers.
Because that's his place, man.
That's his thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, we gotta run now. It's been a good conversation. This is you want to introduce this final song?
Oh yeah. This guy's always consistent.
He's been doing his thing. Kiss Daniel.
But again, I don't know why he doesn't have global. I've never understood why he doesn't have global appeal. Maybe he needs to. I don't know if he can. Maybe he needs to refine something or have the right collaboration, but Kiss Daniel is always consistent when it comes to dropping music. I think he had an album called, his last album, No Bad Songs.
He has released an album after that now.
Maybe two albums ago then, but I know that there were no bad songs really on the album. I don't remember off the top of my head a bad Kiss Daniel song.
Yeah.
So it's called Lie. He's good. It's called Lie, but for some reason. He just isn't
translating. Lie by Kiss Daniel. Check this out. Thank you all.
Everybody done. Don't say I want me. I know the lie. Come for the food. Yeah, I don't really care about your body type. What really matter now your vibe. I'll be the one for you. You don't really have to be the one to go. Ain't nobody fine like you. Girl, I'll be the one for you. And I feel like I've known you my whole life. Feel like I need you. Nobody feel tell me otherwise. Everybody does say, hey, oh, mommy, I know they like. Mama mia, 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 everybody does say, oh, mommy, I know they like. Mama mia, 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 everybody does say, oh, mommy, I know they like. Pick up, pick up, pick up my call. Babizoro, babizoro. Girl, I be the one for you, one for you. My body on you, your body on me. Sweet passion, baby, now you're on your game. Simply because, and I feel like I know you my whole life. Feel like I need you in my life. Nobody can tell me otherwise. This baby will be mine. I feel like I'm on my whole life. Feel like I need you in my life. Nobody can tell me otherwise. Everybody does it. Mama mia, I know they love. Mama mia, 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 mama everybody does say, hey, I'm on the other day. Boy. Everybody.